The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 9th chapter, text number 27 through 29, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 19th, 1966, in New York.
Jat karosi jadasnasi, jat juhosi, davasi jat. जब तपस्वी कौन तेरा कुरुशता मदर्पण हियर इज ए जनरल प्रिस्क्रिप्शन फॉर ऑल पीपल फॉर ट्रांसेंडेंटल रियलाइजेशन ऑफ कृष्ण कॉन्शियसनेस जट करो व्हाट एवर यू डू इट डजंट मैटर सो यू डू इट फॉर कृष्ण. And how to do it, we discussed in the last meeting, that you are doing something, simply change the consciousness that you are doing for Krishna. Nobody is inactive. It is not possible. You cannot be inactive even for a second. Because as living entities, our position is that we shall be always active. Don't you see, as soon as I am out of this body, the body has no more activity. All activity stopped. Again, when I enter another body, my activities from the womb of my mother begin. At the age of 7 months only, the child becomes active. So, spirit soul is always active. So, all these activities should be adopted in Krishna consciousness. Jat karosi, whatever you do. Subhasuri phalairevam mokshasi karma bandhane संन्यास योग युक्तात्मा विमुक्त माम उपैश्यसि. नाउ हियर इज ए न्यूट्रलाइजेशन फॉर्मूला. व्हाट एवर वी आर डूइंग इट हैज गॉट सम रिएक्शन. इफ यू डू पायस एक्ट्स देयर इज गुड रिएक्शन. इफ यू डू इम्पायस एक्शन देयर इज रिएक्शन ऑल्सो. Every action has got its reaction. That we can experience in this material world, that if we eat more, the reaction will be that for 2 days there will be indigestion. Similarly, this material world is so situated that every action has got its reaction. But Krishna says that if you act in Krishna consciousness for Krishna, then there will be no reaction. Subhasuva phalairevam mokshasi karma bandhane. In the 4th chapter, we have discussed that what sort of work we shall do. That is prescribed. Jagyarthe karma annatra lukayam karma bandhana. Karma bandhana means you become bound up by the result and reaction. But if you act for jagyarthe, jagyarthe means for Vishnu or Krishna, then there will be no reaction. Subha subha. Subha means good and asubha means bad. So reaction, either good reaction or bad reaction, you have to take this body. Suppose you are, as a result of your good action, you are going to take your birth in the Rockefeller family of America. That's all right. But so far your body is concerned, the body itself is miserable. Don't think that because you are getting your body in some rich family or in other higher planets, in the demigods planet, where you can have a long duration of life. But still, you have got the material body. And as soon as you get this material body, the reaction of the material body, threefold miseries, and the miseries of birth, the miseries of death, the miseries of old age, and the miseries of disease will continue. Because you are rich man, so you are not immune from the material miseries. That will affect. Therefore, all these material affection will continue. Either you do good work, either you do bad work. So yet he said, Lord Krishna says, Subha Subha Palai Rivam Moksha Se. If you dovetail your activities in Krishna consciousness, then you become liberated from all reactions, either good or bad, transcendent. Because in Krishna consciousness, you are not achieving any future reactionary resultant. Your place will be transcendental, will be transferred to the spiritual world. Therefore, you are free from all reaction. Just the Bhagavad Gita beginning, Arjuna was thinking of so many reactions for his fighting. But when he understood that if I fight for Krishna, there is no reaction, then he fought. So here it is also clearly stated that if you act for Krishna, suppose now, ordinarily, dadasi jat means charity. Charity according to karmakandya vichara, creative activities. Suppose if I give you some charity, say $100 I give you in charity, the reaction will be that I will have to realize $400 from you. That is the law of nature. Besides that, if my money is accumulated in some impious activity, then if you take my money, you will have to suffer. You have to share my reaction. These are the laws of karma, very subtle laws of karma. So, now if you give charity for Krishna activities, then there is no reaction. Of course, there is reaction that is called transcendental reaction, that you will gradually become elevated into Krishna consciousness. So, dadashija. Therefore, everything should be done but Krishna. And if you do like that, then you will neutralize the actions and reactions. Subha Subha, follow you, moksha se, you become liberated. Sannyasa yoga yukta atma vimukta mam upaishyasi. And this sannyasa, renunciation means to become free from the actions and reactions. That is called sannyasa. Sannyasa does not mean that simply taking this orange colored cloth. Sannyasa means to become free from the actions and reactions. Because in the material activities, we are always creating actions and reactions. So at a certain stage of your life, it is recommended, according to the Vedic standard of, order of society, one has to accept the sannyasa order so that he may be free from the actions and reactions. And how one can become free from the actions and reactions? Simply by acting for Krishna. Externally, it appears that you are doing some bad work. Still it will have no obvious. It does not mean that we shall entail our activities with some impious motive. No. Of course, a devotee cannot do that. But in supposing that you have done something which is impious, which you ought not to have done, still it will have no reaction. because the assurance is there. Rāṅtāṁ sarupā vibhāma khvaiṣāmi mā sūcha. The Lord will save you from the reactionary result of even impious activities. Sarva-pāpa. Pāpa means sinful activities. So, a devotee never acts sinful, but supposing that he sometimes consciously or unconsciously does something, there will be no reaction. That is the problem. Sannyasa yoga yukta atma vimukta mām upasyasi. And so long you are not liberated from the actions and reactions, you cannot be liberated. You cannot be liberated. Now, pious activities. Suppose in my whole life I have never done anything impious. I have done simply pious activities. The result of pious activities is janma isadya suta srivi. By pious activities, in your next life, you can get your birth in a very highly respectable aristocratic family. Janma isadya, you can get a great amount of wealth, and janma isadya suta. You can become a highly educated scholar, or you can become a very beautiful. You have a very beautiful body. These things are the result of good activities. Result. Now, suppose I get all these things. That is not my liberation. But we are for liberation. We want to get out of this material contamination. So, good work or bad work, that will not lead me to liberation. The bondage is there. But if you act for Krishna, or you act in Krishna consciousness, then you are liberated. And liberated means you are at once transferred to the spiritual world. Mām upasyasi. Mām means you can get me. You can get me. Samoham sarva-bhuteshu name deshasti na priya je bhajanti tomāna bhaktya maite teshu chāpaham. The Lord says that I am neutral. God is neutral. Samoham sarva-bhuteshu. Samatha means, this point we have discussed, somehow how you, God is neutral, somehow. If he is somehow, some of it is neutral, then how we find different grades of people or different grades of species of life? That is samatha. Now, I'll give you a crude example. Suppose I am a shopkeeper. I have got different varieties of goods. Now, if you pay me less, then I can supply you inferior quality of goods. Another customer is paying me and a good amount, then I am supplying you a superior quality of goods. Now I supply to some customer inferior quality of goods, to another customer I supply superior quality of goods. Is there any partiality? No, that is not partiality. So God gives you result of your action, samoha. He is impartial. If you do good acts, then you get good result. If you do bad acts, then you get bad result. That is samoha, sarva. This is the common formula. The Lord says, samoha sarva bhuteshu name deshasti na priya. It is not that somebody is suffering because God is envious upon him. No, God is not envious. He is suffering his own activities. The same example we can give. Just like a person is ordered by the High Court to be condemned to death. He will be punished, death punishment. Does it mean that the High Court justice is enemy of that particular person? No, he is not enemy. He has created such situation that he is condemned to death. The High Court judge is not responsible for that. He simply administers the, intricacies of law of the state. Similarly, there are agents of law, the material nature, and so many there are agents we do not know. But then in the Shastras we have the Jamaraj, there is the Justice Department, everything is there. So, he is neutral. It is not that God is kind to somebody and unkind to some other. No. His position is always neutral. Samoham sarvabhutesu name deshasya desha means anyone whom I, upon whom I am envious. Of course, our nature is to become envious. Even to enemy or friend, even a friend, develops his material condition, economic development, then we become envious. That is one of the nature of the conditioned soul. Even my son becomes something greater than me, I become envious. So this is nature. But God has no such, crude qualities. He is not envious of anyone. Samoham sarvabhuteshu na me deshasya na priya. Nobody is very dear to him, and nobody is his enemy. But he says, especially, je bhajanti tumang bhaktya, anyone who is engaged in devotional service and Krishna consciousness, maite, he always remains with me. Maite, teshu cha api aham, and I am also with him. A devotee, he cannot be separated, an unalloyed devotee, he cannot be separated from God. Premanjana chrita bhakti vilochanena santa sadaiva ridayeshu vilokayanti. Premanjana, when you have developed love of God, this is quite natural. Just like you, love somebody. You love some person or you always think of it. That is quite natural. Anyway, that is the objective of love. But because our love in this material world is a perverted reflection of the love of God. Love can be applied only to God. In this material world, there is no love. It is all lust. There cannot be any love. The word love can be applied only to God. So these are only perverted reflection, what is going on in the name of love. There is no love. So, the nature of love is this, that the lover wants every moment to see without any remuneration, without any return. That is real love. Real love is described by Lord Chaitanya, his love of God being expressed in one verse, that āśliṣṭa mā pādavatāṁ vinaṣṭa mām marmāhatāṁ karotuvā adarsanā. My Lord Krishna, you embrace me or trample me down at your feet, whatever you like, you can do. And you make me broken-hearted by not being present before me. Because lover wants to see his lovable object. But if the lovable object does not come, he becomes broken-hearted. So Lord Chaitanya says, I am trying to see you, but you do not come. That's all right. I am broken-hearted, but still I shall continue to love you. I cannot detract myself from this love. This is pure love. This is pure love. So, Krishna says, Jitu bhajanti maṁ bhakta, one who is, one is entrapped in such love affairs with God, don't think that God is forgotten. God is also thinking in that way. Although you do not see, but you see, those who are advanced in spiritual consciousness, Krishna consciousness, they always see Krishna. Similarly, as the devotee sees always Krishna, similarly Krishna also always sees that devotee. This is reciprocation. Although he is neutral, he says, I am neutral, but still I cannot deviate myself from my devotee. He is always thinking of me. This is his admission. There is another admission by Krishna about the gopis. The gopis loved him so extensively that Krishna admitted that I cannot return your loving dealings. I am unable. So please be satisfied with your activities. I cannot return. Now just see, God, who is so powerful, he fails to detach the loving objective of the devotee. Samohana sarvabhuteshu name desyasti napriya jetu bhajanti maam pritya. Pritya means with love. We should worship is not applicable to the Supreme Personality of God. The exact word is seva, bhajanti. Here it is, bhajanti. Whenever you will find the dealings between the Supreme Lord and the devotee, the word is used, bhajanti. The bhajanti word cannot be translated into worship. Worship means puja, puja. Just like a worthy gentleman comes, I give him all reception. This is called puja. That may not be love, that is only etiquette. But love is different thing. So, here it is said, jit bhajanti tu. Bhajanti means render service in love. When there is question of love, there is service. Without service, we have got practical experience. Suppose if I love somebody, and if I don't give him something, don't eat something or giving something eatable, then what kind of love it is? That is not love. Love means bhajanti, rendered service. That is love. That is the beginning of love. So if there is no love, if you, under the prescribed rules and regulations, if you simply render service, then you will develop love. This Saranam Kirtana, the class which we are holding, that you are hearing and I am speaking. This is the beginning of love of God. Unless you hear of God, adu saddha, you gentlemen, ladies who come here with some faith. So this faith is the basis of developing love. Adu saddha tatu sadhu sangha tatam bhajana kriya atha anartha nivittisya. So, we have forgotten our relationship with Krishna. Therefore, there is no question of love at the present moment. But we can develop this love by this process. Savanam Kirtana. Bhajanti. Bhajanti means bhakti. Bhakti, the beginning of bhakti or devotional service is to hear. Is to chant and hear. Unless there is chanting, there is no question of hearing. Hear means somebody must be chanting. Either we chant with musical sound or we chant by lectures of Bhagavad Gita. This is all chanting. And others, they are hearing. So this hearing and chanting is the beginning of bhakti, of devotional service. Here it is recommended. Jetu bhajanti maam bhaktya. Anyone who with devotion and love begins this service of hearing chant, savanam kirtanam vishnu smaranam. Smaranam means remembering, smaranam. Samanam kirtanam krishna smaranam pada sevanam archanam bandhanam dasam sakham atmanivedanam. So these are the nine processes of bhakti: hearing, chanting, remembering, offering foodstuff, and cleansing the temple, and offering your earning, jat karosi, jat jyosi, everything, reciprocity, dealing. They are not in activity. This is the bhakti. So, anyone who engages his service, his praning or tridhyavach, service to be rendered with life, with wealth, with words, and with intelligence. No unintelligent man can serve the Supreme Lord. Krishna de bhaje seva rachatu. Only the intelligent class of men, they can serve Krishna, not the unintelligent class. So everything should be done with intelligence, buddhi. Pranai dhatri bhya. Bhya means by intelligence. Bhya and vacha, by words, by your money, by your life. So this is the reciprocation of dealing, of devotional service with Lord. And if there is any devotee who is constantly engaged in such reciprocation of devotional service, God will never forget. Tesu te mai. As He is always unto me, similarly, I am also unto Him. So there is no question of disappointment. Salpamavya sadharma satrayati mahatuha. If you do little thing for the service of the Lord, it is noted in the notebook of Krishna. Don't think that your labor is going in vain. Everything you are, whatever you do sincerely, that is noticed. It is clearly stated here. Teshu te mahi. As they are always constantly thinking of me, similarly, I am also constantly thinking of me. How he can make further development? How he can come to me very quickly? How he can be free from all contamination of the nature? He'll give you intelligence. That is stated in another place, you'll find in the 10th chapter. Isam satadyuktanang bhajatang pridipurvakam. Those persons who are always engaged in love and devotion in my service. Buddhi yogam dadamitam. I give them intelligence. Because intelligence is required. A fool cannot make progress in Krishna consciousness. Only the intelligent person. And that intelligence is supplied by God. He supplies. Dadami buddhi yogam tam. I give him such intelligence. What kind of intelligence? Jena ma upajantite, by which he can quickly come to me. So therefore, our duty is to engage ourselves in Krishna consciousness. There are, and the preliminary rules and regulations, and if we follow, if you follow those principles, it is not very difficult thing to see God or to become acquainted with God intimately. God is very cheap if we adopt the means. Vedesu dullava, adullava atma bhakto. Adullava, adullava, very cheap. To whom? To the pure devotee. But to others, those who are, mongering in philosophical speculation and manufacturing something, some hallucination, it is not possible to have a relationship with God. But adullava, Atma-bhakto is very cheap to the pure devotee. So our duty is to become pure devotee by practice of this Krishna consciousness. And this is not at all difficult. This chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. If you chant, you realize how you are making progress, and gradually Krishna is within you, God is within you. He will give you intelligence that you do this way, you do that way, everything will be clear, and the result will be Tattadeham punarjanmanayati mamayati. After leaving this body, he is gone. Then your human life is perfected. Follow this Krishna consciousness. Thank you.